Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about high resolution gear versus high resolution rooms. Let's face it, today's gear has tremendous advantages over the old analog systems that we use for playback and recording. Unfortunately, the rooms and the quality of the rooms in which the digital formats are used are really not up to the resolution and the headroom and the low noise that we hear from our digital formats, and we enjoy this freedom from all this stuff. Back in the old days when we had analog tape, you know, we had tape hiss, we had all of these issues to deal with, but in today's digital world, we don't have those issues. We have very low noise, we have great headroom, but when you compare that to analog, it's a good thing. But we have to remember that our rooms are in the analog domain. So the same check marks that we have here, low noise, headroom, and things like that, resolution, then, you know, we have to have the same thing going on in our rooms if we're going to realize the benefit of this digital domain. And so we want to make sure that the noise and the headroom and everything in our rooms is comparable, or at least working with the digital domain, and we're not running against ourselves or butting ourselves heads against the wall. So how do we do that? Well, first we construct the correct barrier so we deal with noise. And the noise, remember, is a two-way valve coming out the room and going into the room, okay? So we have to make sure we have the correct barrier design to deal with the frequency and the amplitude or strength of the noise that we're trying to isolate from, both going in and both going out. Door seals, very, very critical. Sound is like water. It'll find the weakest link and get through. So you want to be careful. All of these things contribute to the ambient sound level in your room. And if you don't have each of one of these on control, you know, you're not maximizing the low noise floor of the digital formats that you're working in. Seals are critical. So fans, lights, quiet, got to be quiet. You know, no electrical interference from the lights, no mechanical interference from fans, and please, 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 no glass in the rooms. I mean, to have a digital format with a low noise floor, lots of headroom and stuff like that, and then have a bunch of glass in the room, I mean, what are you trying to do to yourself? What are you trying to do to the music? So make sure all these things are working. Get them, everything aligned together. So the distances to the listening position, the barrier is properly designed for frequency and amplitude of noise. It's airtight, the fans are quiet, the lights are not providing an electrical interference. Complement the digital domain benefits. So high resolution gear requires high resolution rooms. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed our videos today, and if you did, we really would appreciate a thumbs up from you. If you have any questions or comments, you can go to the comment section, or you can go to our website, acousticfields.com, and fill out the contact form. Subscribe to our channel, our YouTube channel. We're now doing 2 videos a week. If you have some ideas for topics, you can submit those to us also. If you're having room issues, we have that free room analysis. You can click on the button below, and we'll compare your room to our database of 120 built rooms that we built and actually measured, and I guarantee you your room is in that database. So just click on the button below for the free room analysis. Thank you.